How would I get up from here? You know where I'm going. I gotta get on that log. But how do you do that? Well, first off, you try not to bust your butt. Nah, I think I'll pass. Joe pass. That's one big ass tree. Well, I built a little bridge. There's like a cave up there. See if I can't get it. Wants to focus in on the leaves in front of it. Turn my walkie-talkie back on. Sits in this curve here. Then you start heading back. Alright. For all you arc lovers out there. There you go. As usual, if y'all see anything, leave a comment down below. I'm gonna head on back down. Take me down where I want to be. Okay, folks, give me a break here, because it's hard to look at the camera and watch where the heck I'm walking. Woo! Tough trail here. Look, there's a couple of caves up there. That one I showed you a while ago. Not very big. That's the walkie-talkie, folks. What is that? Yeah, I'm glad I didn't camp this close to the highway. Well, I tell you what, the camera does not show you how steep this is. And all I need is, just a little more time. All I need is for my knee to go out on me and tumble on down there to the river. Well, you know, it sure can get discouraging out here. Been doing this for almost 3 years and heard wood knocks and found some what I think are tracks. Whoops and howls and smelled stuff and just hadn't seen that old Bigfoot yet. And then you watch these podcasts on YouTube about these people having Bigfoot living in their backyard and they got names for all of them, like family members. And every time somebody goes out on their front door, they find tracks and Bigfoot evidence. And there's a guy on Facebook that swears up and down every time he goes out, he has 10 or 11 of them follow him around. And when he sets up camp, they sit around the wood lines and watch him while he's camping. Just can't wrap my head around that. But you know, I'm not going to let all that stuff get me down. I think I'll keep on looking for Bigfoot. Thank y'all for watching my videos, supporting my channel.